हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई होप यू आर डूइंग ग्रेट। वंस अगेन यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल वाइड लूप रोबोटिक एंड ऑटोमेशन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू डेवलप जनरल पर्पस टाइमर विद STM32F4 न्यूक्लियो बोर्ड। सो लेट अस गेट स्टार्टेड स्टेप बाय स्टेप। दिस इज अवर प्रीवियस प्रोग्राम, इट इज डिले विद सेस्टिक टाइमर। सो नाउ आई विल क्रिएट न्यू प्रोजेक्ट। गो टू प्रोजेक्ट, न्यू प्रोजेक्ट, and go to bag and click here new folder. It is 12, it is general purpose timer. Okay, okay, here I will select controller, so STM32F411RE, and select here SimSys core and startup, then okay. It is simply STM32F4. Expand this, I will edit this. Okay, I will add here .c file, it will be main.c, so main.c add. Okay, now go to target option, select here 16 megahertz and compiler version 5, go to debug, here Stirling debugger. Okay, go to settings and flash download, here check reset and run, and okay. Okay, first of all I will include controller header file, so has include STM32F4XX.h. Now I will create main function, so int main void. Okay, so first of all I will initialize timer, so I will create here a timer initialize function, so void timer 2 underscore init. Okay, I'll copy this and paste here. It is as a prototype function, and now I will start programming for timer. Okay, now I will open dataset. Go to block diagram. Okay, you can see this is general purpose timer, timer 2, timer 3, timer 4 and timer 5. This is timer 2, and here is also timer 9, 10 and 11. Okay, here I will use timer 2. Timer 2 is connected to APB1 bus. So to enable timer 2, we have to enable clock source for APB1 bus. Okay, now I will open reference manual and go to RCC registers. Here we will go to APB1 bus. Okay, this is APB1 ENR. Okay, so 0th bit is dedicated for timer 2 enable, so if it will be 1, then timer 2 will be enable. You can see here 0th bit, if it will be 1, then timer clock enable. Okay, so RCC APB 1 ENR. It will be 1 left shifted by 0. Okay. Now we will go to timer resistors. This is timer resistors. Click over here. And we will go to pre-scaler. So this is PSC. So first of all, we will decide pre-scaler and ARR. This is auto reload resistors. So I will tell you how to calculate. So team 2 PSC equal to and timer 2, it will be ARR equal to, we are going to generate here 1 hertz timer frequency. So remember our system clock is 16 megahertz, so we need pre-scaler. Okay, so here it will be 16,000. I will tell you how to calculate this. Remember our system clock is 16 megahertz, so it will be 16 million divided by 16,000. So its value will be 100,000, right? And now this is auto reload resistor. I will assign here 1000 minus 1. Because here it is 1000, so 1000 divided by 1000, 1000 divided by 1000, it will be 1. So here it will generate 1 hertz or 1 second timer. Okay, and here I am using minus 1, it means it counts from 0. Okay, now again we will go to reference manual. So here this is timer counter. So by default timer counter will be 0. So I will keep here team 2 CNT equal to 0, right? It will clear timer. Okay. Now we will go to control resistor, timer control resistor. So timer 2 CR1 equal to, we will go to timer control resistor. So here you can see 0th bit. If 0th bit will be 1, then counter will be enabled. If it will be 0, then counter will be disabled. So we have to set 0th bit. Okay, so I will type here 1 left shifted by 0. Okay, enable counter. Okay, now this function is ready. Here I will blink LED. LED is connected on PA5 number pin. So first of all, we have to enable clock source for port A. So RCC AHB1 enable, because port A is connected to AHB1 bus. Okay, it will be 1 left shifted by 0. Okay. And now GPIO A mode resistor. It will be output. So we have to make PA5 number pin as a output. So 1 left shifted by 10. Okay. Now I will use here while loop. It is infinite loop. okay, and I will use again while loop. I will check here flag register of status register in timer. Timer 2 SR register, and so we will go to timer status register. We will check 0th bit because you can see here update interrupt flag. Okay, if it will be 0, then no update occur. When it will be 1, then update interrupt pending. This bit is set by hardware when the register are updated. Okay, so we will check 0th bit. One left shifted by 0. Okay. I will use here NOT operator because if it will be 0, then it will wait for set the flag. When flag will be set, then while loop will be false. Now clear the flag. Timer 2 SR register and equal to negate this, it is 1. Okay. And now toggle the LED GPIO A ODR 1 left shifted by 5 because I am going to toggle PA5 number LED. Okay, here it is not OR, this is here XOR operator. Okay, so I think code is ready. Here if flag will be 0, then it will wait for flag to be set. Okay, when flag will be set, then while loop will be false. Then here and LED will be toggle. Okay, now code is ready. Once I will build this code, click on build. Now upload the code. Why LED is not blinking? Okay, we have to call this function. Again build, and there is one errors and three warnings. Okay, again build and load. Wow, you can see LED is blinking with 1 second delay. It means we have generated 1 hertz frequency. Okay, or 1 hertz frequency timer. Okay, so friends, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you really like this video, so you can support me on PayPal. My PayPal account has given in description box, and don't forget to like, subscribe and share. Thanks for watching.